What you're seeing is all too familiar to all of you. Images from the civil uprising in the days that followed the murder of George Floyd. But tonight, we're going to talk about freedom of the press and the journalists who say they were attacked by officers as they covered that story. Eight of them filed a lawsuit against the Minneapolis Police Department. And today, the city council unanimously agreed to a $950,000 settlement. But it's not the first suit over mistreatment of journalists at that time. The ACLU settled a similar case against the State Patrol for $825,000 in 2022. And tonight, Jennifer Hoff had the opportunity to talk to some of the reporters who filed this suit. Hi, Jennifer.
Hi, Jenna. And yeah, they'll be the first to tell you that the settlement provides some measure of justice, of course, but that it doesn't erase the trauma from nearly 4 years ago when Minneapolis became the epicenter of violence and police reform. It's impossible to forget what happened nearly 4 years ago when a former Minneapolis police officer killed George Floyd and protests erupted across the city.
It was scary.
Maggie Kurth lived in Uptown near a lot of the violence, reporting then for a political publication.
I'm a science reporter. This is not like a type of situation I had really ever expected to be in, and I didn't want to not be part of documenting the reality of the situation.
She cobbled together safety gear and was interviewing a man she says police shot with a rubber bullet when officers then targeted her despite showing her press credentials.
One of the police officers yelled at me, "I really want to peg you," basically just how much he wanted to shoot us and didn't, and then one of them yelled at us to shut up.
Her experience is outlined in a lawsuit filed by journalist Jared Goyette, who was working alongside Kurth, that details incidents law enforcement intentionally tear gassed, detained, attacked, and fired less than lethal projectiles at them, many of which were documented, eroding not only trust, but the role of journalists established in the Constitution.
You're left in this position of like, I thought that there were, maybe naively, but I thought that there were rules to this because it put me in an adversarial position with people that, like, with institutions that I had to cover, and I still had to make a living.
Which is the litigation matter of Jared Goyette et al. Versus the city of Minneapolis.
Today, the city council agreed to settle that lawsuit for $950,000, split amongst eight journalists, including Goyette, represented in part by the American Civil Liberties Union of Minnesota.
We should not have to have these fights. We should not have journalists going out to cover protests, being afraid that they will be arrested or that they will be brutalized and shot with rubber bullets and or worse when they're doing that coverage, because that kind of fear makes it chilling for journalists, makes it less likely that people are going to go out and do that coverage.
The legal director saying this settlement sends a strong message about the freedom of the press that Kurth also shares.
If you can't protect the public without harming the public and without getting in the way of the public's right to know how you are behaving, there is a problem there.
This is at least the second suit Goyette has filed since then, when he says police shot him with a rubber bullet during his reporting. The other one also settled with the State Patrol.
It's not like spiking a football. It's not like, yeah, this is, it doesn't feel like that. It's like, I think we had a good impact. Like, I think we did help improve a situation.
The city says it has now paid more than $11 million stemming from police conduct during that unrest that journalists say is a sign they'll keep standing up for what's right.
And I'm really proud to be a part of, I guess, holding the city accountable for that.
Now, the city is quite limited in how it can actually respond due to its fiduciary duty to the plaintiffs. However, Councilmember Paul Masano said in a statement that she thinks this was the best decision for the city in this case and is pleased that all of her colleagues agreed. Meanwhile, Goyette and other journalists and the ACLU are also still in litigation with the Hennepin County Sheriff's Office. They're filing a suit against that organization, Jana, as well, and that case could very well be headed to trial.
Now, I know a lot of people that are watching remember those nights, probably watching Care 11 or another station 4 years ago, where it was just chaos all over the streets where we were covering it, and maybe thinking, well, you couldn't tell one person from another. But, you know, we had press badges that were almost poster size at that time. I mean, we were identified.
And there were instances where I think we almost made our press badges look different. We made them bigger. We made them more noticeable. And for that purpose, for that exact purpose. So, yeah, you make a very good point about that.